डिस्कशन टॉपिक इज टाइप्स ऑफ टेस्टिंग. द टाइप्स ऑफ टेस्टिंग विच आर डन फॉर द सॉफ्टवेयर टू मेक इट परफेक्ट सो दैट ऑल द बग्स एंड एरर्स कैन बी रिमूव्ड. सो टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ टेस्टिंग टेक्निक्स. सो द वेरियस कॉन्टेंट दैट वी आर गोइंग टू कवर आर मैंशनड ओवर हेयर. लेट स्टार्ट विद द टाइप्स ऑफ टेस्टिंग. We are having two major types. The first one is functional testing of the software. The second one is non-functional testing of the software. Let's begin with the functional testing. If we talk about the introduction about functional testing, it means that we will check only the functionality of the software. We will not consider about the internal products and we will just focus on the output. How the software is responding to the different inputs and producing the output. And if the product is producing output according to the user's requirement, it means that it is functionally operating very good. So we are having different types of testing. We can consider the black box testing, which we will discuss further in the later on slides. So here we will discuss why the functional testing is really important for the softwares. What we will check in the functional testing? The first one is mainline functions. Mainline means that we will focus only on the main functions which are really mandatory for the software to perform. The next is basic usability. Whether the software is able to navigate from one page to second page, one screen to second screen, that is basic usability. Accessibility means that whether the user is really very capable to access the system or operate the system in the proper manner or not. And the last is error conditions. The software developed by the organization must ensure that if in case there are any kind of errors, then error message must be displayed over there. If in case, otherwise the system should work really good according to the need. So these are the types of functional testing, like unit testing, integration testing, then system sanity, smoke testing, then we are having interface testing, regression testing, alpha and beta testing, and in the last we will discuss about white box and black box testing. Let's begin with the unit testing. Unit testing means that we will check the entire software module by module, means that unit by unit we will check each and every source code which is done by the developer or the programmer. So that is called as unit testing. Next is integration testing. Integration means that simply we discuss about the meaning of the integration, which means that we just need to combine the modules. So here all the integrated modules will be checked, whether the individual applications, and it will be checked according to the client and server application, so that it will be really good to work on the network according to the need. So that will be called as integration testing. Next is system testing. System testing means that finally when the product is ready, it has to be tested overall. Like entire system will be tested whether it is producing any kind of errors or bugs, or if in case it is producing any error, then the error page must be displayed over there to the user. So that is system testing. Next we are having sanity testing. Sanity testing means that here we need to determine if a new software version which is developed, it is well good to be accepted for the major testing. So that is called as sanity testing. So once the software is tested, if it is crashing or some kind of undesired output is producing, then it has to be modified in the initial stages only. Then we are having smoke testing. Smoke testing means that this testing technique is really used to ensure that the build, the structure which is developed, it is really very stable for the further testing. So it must not cause any kind of error or bugs. If the tester finds any kind of bug or error in the initial stages, then the software team which is developing the software, it will reject the build or the structure and it will create the new one. So that is the smoke testing. Next, we are having interface testing. Interface testing is used to verify whether the communication between the two different softwares or the application is working good. They are working in the coordinated manner in the well-performed structure. So that will be called as interface testing. Let's move to the other testing techniques. Regression testing. If we are testing the application as a whole, then the whole process, the whole system for the modification will be done if there are any kind of problem. That will be called as regression testing. Because the reason being, it is really difficult to cover all the systems in the regression. So we are having some tools and techniques which are used for the regression testing. Then we are having alpha testing. Alpha testing means that it is the testing of the entire software by the developer team in the organization itself. So it is really different from the beta testing. Here it is done for the software development. It is performed in the virtual environment, the alpha testing. But in case we want to get the check, we want to get the software to be checked in the other environment, like if we say real life environment by the real users, that will be called as beta testing. If we talk about like before some years before Facebook, we are having some other social networking websites like Orkut. So it was a beta version. At that time, it was not working that much good and it was not according to the user's requirement perfectly at that time. So it was for the beta testing. So beta testing means that if we are releasing the entire product to the customer and we are then getting the feedback from the customer, and if the feedback is not good, if the user is demanding for any kind of updation and we are doing some updations also, then it will be called as the beta testing. So next we are having types of other some functional testing techniques, that is black box and white box testing technique. In the black box, what will happen? It is a method where the software will be tested for the functionality of the software only, for the application. Here we will not focus about any kind of internal structure or internal working. So here we will focus on the functionality overall. So that will be called as black box testing. Next we are having white box testing. It is totally opposite to the black box testing, where we will test the internal structures and working of the application also. So these are opposite to each other, black box testing and white box testing. Now let's discuss some of the important points related to the software testing as a conclusion. So on the whole, we can say that software testing is really important. Without software testing, it is really very difficult to deliver the product to the customer. So it is to identify the completeness and the correctness of the software which is being developed by the organization. Here we can consider that it really checks for various things like errors, bugs, faults, failure, etc. There are different meanings to all these words. Error means that it is created by the human action and if it creates any kind of undesired output. Then about the bugs. Bugs means that if the software produces any error during the execution of the instructions. Then is fault. It is the state of software which is really caused by some kind of error further. So we can say that if errors are happening in the software, it will be resultant to faults. It will lead to faults. Then finally, failure can be the case the deviation of the software from its expected result and it is creating something out of the context, then we can say that the software developed by the organization is failed. So these are some important points. Now let's discuss some really important MCQs related to the same topic we have discussed right now. So the question is, an organization wants to release the product in the market in order to get the feedback and the proper working of the software. So it will be called as which of the following type of testing? So the various options are given. What is the correct answer? Correct answer will be option number one, beta testing. Beta testing means that if we are releasing the entire product in the real life world to the real users. Next question is, dash testing is used to determine if a new software version is performing well enough to accept it for a major testing effort. So what is the correct answer for this question is option number two, sanity testing. So it is the definition of the sanity testing where we need to check the newly developed version of the software, whether it is performing according to the need of the customer so that it can be perfectly done for the testing in the major environment, in the real world environment. Thus, it was all about the different types of testing under functional testing. Thank you so much.